Hello friends, welcome to the channel Trading Strategies. Today we are going to learn about a new technique, how to trade intraday and make decent profits without using any technical charts. So we all know that we'll use candlesticks, charts with indicators, moving averages, a lot of technical things. But without any chart, how we can trade every day and make money in the stock market? So some people asked me, why should I use a candlestick? I don't know how to understand the candlesticks and everything. Without understanding any candlesticks, without any technical indicators, without technical chart itself, you can trade in the stock market and make money. Only you have to follow certain rules. Strictly according to the rules, you can trade. Now I will show you how to trade. So we have to we'll see now how to trade stock market without any technical charts. So I'll show you the terminal. This is the terminal, right? This is the chart normally we'll use for trading. So I'm removing this chart. So friends, please watch this video till the end. So I'll give you all the information how you can trade without any technical charts and technical indicators. So here, what are the prices you will see? In any terminal, you will be knowing the current price and open price. So our concentration is on the opening price. Based on this opening price, how we will trade the next on the day. So we have to be there in the market at 9 a.m. So we will be knowing this open price at 8 a.m. 9 morning, 9 o'clock, 8 minutes, you will get this open price. From 8 to 8:15, you have 7 minutes of time where you have to calculate a certain price points. Based on that, you can trade. That I will show you how to see. First thing is, before opening the market, identify the stocks to trade for intraday. So you have your own method, which stock you want to trade, that you know very well. So you identify one stock, two stocks or three stocks, whatever the number of stocks you want to trade, you note it down, you put it on your terminal, right? So note the opening price of the particular stock, what you want to trade at 8 a.m. Calculate the daily range of the stock, right? How to calculate, I'll show you now, and divide the range in three parts. So now I'll go to this how to calculate the range. I'll show you in suppose example, you are selected, say Axis Bank you selected, Balakrishna you selected, or Biocon you selected, some stocks you selected, right? So whatever the stock you selected, you can keep it in your watch list and you note down the opening price. So we have to calculate the day range for that particular stock, right? For that, what the components we need is opening price and the daily volatility of that particular stock. So how to get that daily volatility? Just we'll go to the NSE website. So this is the NSE website. Okay, I'll show you from the this is the old website, right? So if you want, this is a old website, better go to old website, and here you select the products and equity. Here go to historical data, then archive of daily reports. Here you select the report, that report is daily volatility files. So you select the date. So suppose you are trading on 22nd, you have to take 21st report. Get data, download it, right? Open in Excel, right? So this is the Excel. So I selected Axis Bank. This is the G column is daily volatility. So I'll show you. This is the symbol, underlying price at previous day price. This is the difference, and this is the previous day volatility. This is the current day volatility. Current day underlying daily volatility. This is the formula they use. So this volatility is important for us. For all the stocks I downloaded, but I may need only 2 or 3 stocks, or 1 stock, 2 stocks. So that time you can select the stock from here. So this download process and taking this volatility file, you can do in the morning itself. So before opening the market itself, right? So now I am just selecting for calculation purpose Axis Bank, right? Where is the Axis Bank? So this is the Axis Bank, right? So this is the date, 21st May, Axis Bank. This is the closing price, and see that is immaterial for closing and all these things. Only we need is the G column. This G column is the volatility. So based on this volatility, this is the range. So 19.54. How I calculated? I took the opening price. Where is my opening price? 352 rupees 10 paisa opening price, Axis Bank. This is the Axis Bank. This is the opening price. So 352 10 paisa, right? If you don't want to use Excel, you can calculate on piece of paper using your calculator, right? So this is the range. So what I have to do is the next step. I have to divide this range in 3 parts. Here, what I am saying is simple calculation. This range into 0.236. Friends, you may ask why 236? I'll tell you that also. First, we'll calculate the range. The first range is 4.61. So here I'll format this to number. Right? This is the first step. So range 1. This I am calling as A. Right? The second step is B. So B here. Right. So how to calculate this B? B is equal to the range into 0.618. I think some people may understand why I'm using 236 and 618, right? So the simple thing is, I'm a fan of Fibonacci. I use most of the times Fibonacci ratios, Fibonacci numbers only. So that's why I'm taking these 2 Fibonacci ratios, 23.6 and 61.8. The third one is called C. The C is nothing but the range. So these are the 3 points what I got, right? So how to trade now? The rules for the trading, I'll show you. So A, B, C, 3 price points, I got it. So 4 rupees 60 paisa, 12 rupees 8 paisa, 19 rupees 54 paisa. The idea is, the range means, if after opening the market, price may maximum go up to this opening price plus this, that is upside, and opening price plus this minus. So that means the standard deviation of that particular stock one standard deviation I am calculating. It's a mathematical calculation. Statistically, one standard deviation is the high probability. 66% of the time, the range is one standard deviation, right? Very rare cases, it may go up to two standard deviation. So, I am calculating one standard deviation, and that one standard deviation, I am dividing with the Fibonacci ratios, right? So, so this is the thing. Before opening the market, identify the stocks to trade for intraday. Note the opening price of the stock at 9:08 a.m. Calculate the daily range of the stock. Divide the range in three parts, A, B, C, right? The next trading rule. So, trading rule is simple. Yeah. So, this is simple. So, trading rule, how we have to trade? There are five rules. So, one is buy if the price above open plus A, sell if the price below open minus A, close your buy position at open plus B, close your sell position at open minus B. Stop loss is open price. See, this is not exactly open price. You can select as per your risk appetite, right? So, you have to wait first 5 minutes to over the market. At 9:20, you have to take these rules. So, I'll show you how this also in a Excel. See, what is the rule? Rule number one is if the price goes open plus A, that is equal to open price is 391 plus 20 paisa plus A. So, this is buy. And the target is open 391.20 plus 12 rupees 8 paisa. So, this is the target. If you are buying at 395.80 paisa, and taking your profit at 403.25 paisa, right? So, if you are having number of stocks, say about you are trading 200 stocks, you take 100 stocks profit here, the second lot is one standard deviation, that is 392.1 plus this one, C. This is the final. So, this way, this is the buy, right? So, on the sell side, what we have to do is, the price is equal to open 392.10 minus this. If the price goes below 387, you can sell and opening price as a stop loss and take your profit, this 392.1 minus 12 rupees 8 paisa, that is 380. So, you are selling at 387.45 paisa and booking your profit is 380 rupees. So, 7 rupees 40 paisa is your also. 7 rupee 40 paisa is your profit. So, this way you can do whatever the stock you want to trade, you can trade. And also Nifty and Bank Nifty also you can trade with this same formula. For one more thing I want to show you, if you don't want to calculate number of stocks, you want to calculate only one or two stocks or only one stock you want to calculate, very easy method. You need not download all these things. You just go to NSE site and I'll show you how to take that. Friends, just we'll summarize the so far what we learned. So first, before opening the market, identify the stocks to trade for intraday. Note the opening price of the stock at 9:08 a.m. Calculate the daily range of the stock using the daily volatility and divide the range in three parts. So in the three parts, we calculate, we given one A, B, C, three numbers. So after opening the market at 9:15, wait for 5 minutes. So then you buy if the price above the open price plus A, sell if the price below the open price minus B, and close your buy position if it reaches open plus B, and sell your close your sell position at open minus B, keep a stop loss at opening price. This is what we learned so far. So now we saw one example also. So this is the Axis Bank. This is the opening price, and as per the NSE site, we are not calculated the daily volatility. We corrected from the NSE website. This is the daily volatility 0.0555. So open into daily volatility is equal to one standard deviation of that particular stock. That is 19.54. So what we did is A. So we have to calculate the ABC. A is the range into 0.236, that is 4 rupees 61 paisa. B is the range into 0.618, that is 12 rupees 8 paisa. C is the volatility, right? So if the price is above opening price plus this 4 rupees 61 paisa, so then we have to buy and book a profit at open price plus 12 rupees 8 paisa. Simultaneously, if goes down, sell below this and book profit here. So this is a simple example I have shown. And now I'll show you, if suppose you want to trade if one or two stocks in F&O. So in futures especially. So how to take the future stock volatility, not downloading all the total file. So I'll show you in NSE website. This is NSE website, new one. I'm going to old site. This is a old site. Here you select the equity derivative and take same Axis Bank I'm taking, right? You will get the quote here, right? So this is the quote. So here VWAP, underlying, open interest, everything, it will come here. You take other information, you just click here, you will get daily volatility 5.57%. So you have to take this 5.57 in your calculation, use 0.0557. In equity, it has shown 0.0555. In future, it has shown 0.0557. So even in equity also, you can take this volatility and calculate. It doesn't give much difference. Maybe 50 paisa, 10 paisa, 15 paisa variation will come. So doesn't worry. Don't worry about that. So if you want to trade Nifty, right? So you go to equity derivative and type Nifty, right? Nifty 50. Here you can take the volatility. So this daily volatility is 2.67. In calculation purpose, what we have to take is, we have to take the opening price. This is 9001. It opened into 0.0267 is the factor, multiplication factor. Then you get the range. So if that also, you can trade even Nifty, Bank Nifty also, right? So if you see the Bank Nifty here, you can take Bank Nifty, or you can straight away here, it will come Bank Nifty, expiry, get data. So this is the Bank Nifty volatility is 0.0385, right? So I'll show you just for example, for Bank Nifty, how we calculate. right? So here there is a simple thing. What I did do is Bank Nifty daily volatility is 0.0385. So 0.0385. This is the volatility, daily volatility. So DEV and the open price is equal to, so what is the opening price? You can even see in the NSE website itself. This is Bank Nifty open is 17,499.50 paisa, right? So I am putting 17,499.50. So what is the range? This into this, so that is the range. So one standard deviation of the Bank Nifty is 673. So if price goes above 673 of the opening price, that is a big hurdle for the stock. And goes downside also, if goes below this plus this, is a big hurdle. So we have to divide this into three parts, like A, B, C, and we have to calculate as per the example I shown in my Axis Bank. So Axis Bank example, same thing, you have to calculate the Bank Nifty also. This way you can trade without any charts, only mathematical calculations. Friends, nothing, the money won't come just like that. You have to do some homework and you have to do some calculations and you follow the rules, then only you will get the money. This will give you the consistent profits in the stock market. You may get some stop losses, but the hitting ratio will be very high. More than 70% of the time this will happen. So for automation purpose, if you are really interested, you can send a WhatsApp to me. I will send you the Excel file. So that simply I'll show you. So this actually how I taken from the data. This is the data. This is the terminal I am using, ShareKan. What I'll do is I'll go and I'll export the data to Excel, and in Excel, so this is the Excel, this is the live data. So in live market the data will be updating, and this is the another sheet which is called work area. So in work area I done some formulas. So this is the formula what I used. So I told you, na 0.326, if above this price I will, here the automatically signal will come as buy, and after reaching this stock it will show you close. So this automation, if you are really interested, you can send a WhatsApp message to me. I'll send you the Excel file. So friends, if you like this video, please share it to your friends. If you really make some profits out of this concept, please text me in my WhatsApp number. Thank you friends, thank you for watching this video. If you like, please share it to your friends, give a thumbs up. If you are not subscribed, please subscribe.